Townsville in Queensland, Australia is a seaside city with a rich swimming history. It was here in the Tobruk Memorial Baths that the Australian swimmers prepared for the 1956 Melbourne Games, where they won an astounding 8 of 13 events. It is also the city where Libby Lenton was born and where she learned to swim. By age 10, Libby was one of Queensland's top age groupers, but her career lagged until she started training under Stefan Widmar in Brisbane at the age of 17. The next year, Libby won gold and silver in the 50-meter and 100-meter freestyle and a bronze in the 100-meter butterfly at the 2003 Telstra Australian Championships in Sydney. A year later, swimming in the preliminaries of the 100-meter freestyle at the Australian Olympic Trials, Libby held both hands over her face in shock when she looked at the scoreboard and saw she had touched the wall in a new world record time of 53.66 seconds. She was the first Australian woman to hold the record in this event since Shane Gould in 1973. Libby qualified for and swam in three events in Athens, earning a bronze medal in the 50 free and a gold in the 4x100-meter freestyle relay when the team overtook Team USA on the final leg to win the event for the first time in 48 years. Libby cemented her position among the world's top swimmers in 2005, first at the Montreal FINA World Championships by reeling in gold in the 50-meter freestyle, silver in the 100-meter butterfly, and two golds and a silver for the three relays. Back in Australia, she twice broke the world record in the 100-meter freestyle at the Telstra Australian Short Course Championships. In 2006, Libby won five gold medals at the Commonwealth Games in Melbourne. It was then on to Shanghai for the Short Course World Championships, where she repeated her performance, winning five of Australia's 12 gold medals and was named leading female swimmer of the meet. Libby won five more gold medals at the 2007 FINA World Championships in Melbourne. A week later, at the third USA-Australia Duel in the Pool in Sydney, she led off the 4x100 mixed relay against Michael Phelps. Although Phelps beat her to the wall, her time of 52.99 broke the world record of Britta Steffens by nearly a third of a second. 3 days later, on April 7th, Libby married longtime love and fellow Australian swimmer Luke Trickett. It was while on their honeymoon that Libby learned that FINA refused to recognize her record. But in March of 2008, Libby Trickett broke Britta Steffens' record again at the Australian Championships with a time of 52.88. At the 2008 Beijing Olympic Games, Libby won a total of five medals, two golds and bronze in the relays, and individually she won gold in the 100-meter butterfly and silver in the 100-meter freestyle. Libby briefly retired from swimming in 2009, but decided to return to competition in 2010 and earned a spot on Australia's 4x100 freestyle relay team that won her another gold medal at the 2012 London Olympic Games. Libby retired in 2013 for the final time. And in 2015, Libby gave birth to daughter Poppy. Despite her great success in the pool and ever-present smile, Libby has struggled with depression throughout her career. Working with sports psychologists and by seeking that advice and guidance, Libby says that the biggest lesson she learned was that it's okay to ask for help, and that help is really valuable. Libby Trickett, Honor Swimmer, Australia.
Thank you. That was like going back in time. It's like a little time capsule of a very big part of my life. I first of all have to say thank you so much to the International Swimming Hall of Fame for putting on tonight. It's actually my first night out since having my second baby daughter 3 months ago. So thanks for putting on a night out. It's very exciting for me. I did have to come all the way from Australia, but you know, it's worth it. There's so many people that I would absolutely love to thank. I could be here for hours with the amazing experiences that I've had throughout my swimming career. It's been it was absolutely my first love of my life, all the way back in Townsville, learning to swim, all the amazing coaches that I've been able to work with. I have to thank particularly Stefan. He took my swimming to an entirely different level, and one of my favourite memories of working with Stefan was within the first 6 months, the first 6 weeks of working with Stefan, I remember him saying to me that within 12 months you won't recognise who you are as a swimmer in your swimming career, the trajectory that you're on. And I remember absolutely laughing in his face and saying, you have no idea what you're talking about. But within 12 months, I had broken my first world record and made my first Olympic team. So it really shows the power of great coaches who show that support and encouragement to their athletes and what that can do for their swimming careers. So thank you to all the coaches out there doing amazing work in the sport that we love. It would be remiss of me not to mention my mother, who helped in every sense of the word, obviously. She gave me life, but more importantly, she's helped and supported me every step of my swimming career. She was one of my first believers of my ability, and she did everything in her power to allow me to get to this point of being recognised in the International Swimming Hall of Fame. So thank you to her. She's also looking after my almost three-year-old and my three-month-old up in the room at the moment. So a very big thank you to her and all that she's done for me. And finally, I'd like to thank my husband, who swimming has honestly given me everything in my life. I met Luke through swimming on our very first youth team together. He was the swimmer of the meet at our Oceania Championships. He was a 200 breaststroker and kind of fell pretty head over heels in love from the very minute that I met him, although he thinks it was different. he's given me the world. Without a doubt, he taught me how to train hard. I didn't know what working hard in the training pool was like until I met him, and that allowed me to really progress my swimming and my racing. So a very big thank you to him and all that he's done for me in supporting my career and including encouraging me to be here, because with a three-month-old, I really wasn't sure I'd be able to make it. But he said, this is probably the last time you'll get any sort of recognition in swimming. So... You better do it. So very, very thank you to him and everyone. I really hope you enjoy the rest of your night. Thank you very much.
Presenting the mantle to Libby is the immediate past chairman of the International Swimming Hall of Fame, two-time Olympian, double Olympic gold medalist from 1964, the one and only great broadcasting Hall of Fame person, by the way, Donna DeVerona.